Alright guys, so today we got the Bamboo Lab A1 Mini. This is a very small printer. It's a 180 by 180. But it is made by Bamboo Lab. It's supposed to be a really good printer, even though it's a small printer. I decided on this one instead of the big one because I just don't have the space right now for the big one. I'm hoping this will fit fine on my shelf with my P1S sideways. If it doesn't, then I'm going to have to fix around, take some stuff up and down and whatnot. I'm kind of curious, because this is going to be more of like your beginner printer, what all is actually included. So far, got a tool kit. There's some greases in there. I'm wondering how hard it's going to be completely assembled. Grab this out. Throw this back behind here. This is a good idea, but I'm going to try it. Then you get your printer. Comes in this bag here. Oops. So here is the tiny little printer. This thing is so cute. Oops. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'll bring it over here to my shelf. A couple other things in here. Some little thing of white filament. Some extra PTFE tubing, and your little tool kit, and that looks to be it. So, we'll leave this mess for right now, I'll clean it up later, and then we'll go over to the printer and take a look. So in these printers, guys, Bamboo is very good. They send a startup manual, the extra little parts, and this is for your filament, so we're going to have to take a look here. Move some of this foam, I'm guessing. Let's do that quick now. Bill plate tape with your slicer setting. Fill the bill plate fully cools down to remove prints. Clean the bill plate regularly for best adhesion. Little instruction thing there. I'll kind of try to stand on this side and not block the light from you guys. Tells you everything you should get. And then your startup. So we gotta cut this off. Make sure you're not clipping any wires, guys. Just that. That off, and then now it says pull these out, and it says something about the three screws under here, so we'll take a look. Must be these three on the outside, so we'll grab our little toolkit that's included. Sorry guys, I know you're not able to see much over here. Get a nice little toolkit with it. Take a look at that, 1 second. Okay, so now that's all done, we are gonna get this little flicker on here. Looks like it's gonna go on. Just like that, and then it says there's an M3 screw. So I didn't see any M3 screws in here. Oh, they're in the toolkit, very cool. For purge wiper. Now I'm just going to kind of turn it around. Notice how I'm using all hand tools for this guy. I do not suggest you use electric tools. Don't need to over tighten it, just tighten it on there. Okay, so now that's on there. Now we are gonna do this install. And this don't have a screw that goes in it, so let's turn this around here. I'm not freaking sure where it goes. So here, oh okay, I see, this is actually a lock. There's that. So now the spool holder base plate should be this. So you guys, you do got a little bit of work to do when you get this out of the box. It's not as simple as just pulling it out, starting her up. I thought this was going to be a lot easier to start up, but apparently not, and that's fine. This is not an AMS model, just so if I didn't mention that for anyone. So then this, and lift this up. And that looks like about it. There with that. Now, I'm gonna plug the power cable in. Snap it on. Unleash your creativity. Well, that's kind of cool. This in, and then I'll be back. It does have a slot over here, which is very cool. Okay, so it's gonna calibrate quick. I don't know if they're filming it or not right now, but I don't. Doesn't say in there specifically what slot you're supposed to put it in, but we're gonna put it in that one, I guess. And then let's do some blue filament. Kind of see the filament going through here. I'm not gonna actually put it in yet. Just gonna put it like that. When it gets done calibrating, I will come back. This is still going, so we'll let it run. I'll keep going, and then when it's done, I'll come back. Now calibration has completed. Make sure we're doing everything correct. Okay, so I'm gonna look up here, and I'll read this, and then I'll show you guys how to do it. I'm letting it update the firmware here quick while I watch how to do this, and then we'll do it. So basically, the gist I got is you open up this bottle, you have a little tiny end here, clip that off. Make sure you clip it off all the way. There we go. And it's gonna need a bit just like this. Go like that, that should be good. Then when it gets done updating,
I'm gonna kind of just use my finger.
But I'll grab a wet wipe and I'll wipe off the excess I dripped. Wipe that off carefully. Just like that. Still updating. We got the P1S going. This printer's been pretty solid. I've had some problems with the AMS. I will update everyone on that. I haven't actually done a video on this printer yet. Just because I was so excited about getting it out and get it going so I can get some stuff printed for customers. And so yeah. So I'll do a video on this one soon too. So, should be good to go. So it's heating the nozzle up to load the filament in. Way over here to the side. Should be fine. One, two, make sure. Okay, there the filament comes. Now it should be purging. Oh, cool. Okay, so now we got filament in it. Back, print files. Let's do a benching. Thank you. So it is heating up the bed right now. When it starts, I will come back. Now it is leveling. When the print sheet actually starts printing, I will come back. Yeah, switch it. So that is sport, standard. The heat is kind of high for the nozzle. Oh, it's at 220. We'll leave it at 20. 220, I guess. So it should be going down here. But yeah, I'm going to let that print, and then I'll be back in a little bit to check on you guys. Looks like you got about 14 minutes. There we go, guys. Comes off pretty easy. Really high quality. I mean, it looks really good. See the lines, of course, and there's a little mix up there, but otherwise it looks really good. So cool. So put that to the side. Printing complete. Okay. Now I did bring my phone. I want to print out this lamp. This didn't come with this. You can get 2 free kits right now at Micro Center. So yeah, let's print that out quick. And I'm not going to leave the camera on for that. I will just print that out normal. And then we'll look at it when it's done. Alright guys, so it is starting that print. However, I'm going to end the video here. If you would like to see how my lamp turns out, make sure you like and subscribe, and I will post it in my posts on my community page so everyone can kind of see it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I give this printer definitely a thumbs up. It is a great little printer. It's doing what it's supposed to do. I haven't had an issue yet. I will come back in a month and update everyone on this printer. If I do have some issues, but I don't see myself having any issues. Bamboo makes pretty solid stuff from what I've seen. The P1S has been a good printer so far for the last week. The AMS I'm not as big of a fan is, and I will make a video on why that is. But for this thing, so far, it's great. Thank you guys so much for watching. Drop them a like, and then don't forget to subscribe, guys. I really